Hi all, in this video, let's understand what is a storybook, why should we use this storybook while we are developing the front-end web applications like React, Angular, and Vue.js. So let's understand this. So this is a storybook and an example of storybook, how it looks. This is an example of GitLab's UI storybook. So it looks in this way. So let me explain you what is the purpose and the usage of using the storybook. So coming to the first point, the development of isolated components. So let's come back to this. See, in any of the bigger projects, so you're about to start a project. So what you're going to do in all these web applications, you need to develop independent components. So the smaller components you can develop, you're developing those small components. So you're developing small components. Where to visualize these components? All the independent components you can, if you want to visualize, still the application was not yet ready. You need to integrate all the components to see an application or a page. So still the application was not ready. You need to develop independent components. So this is the best place to check how the component looks. So each and every component you can isolatedly develop here and you can check how it looks. So this is a place you can use like a playground for the UI development. So this is the first point. So coming to the second point, component library documentation. So what does it exactly mean? So I will explain you this. So in the applications in your project or in your products you are developing, the applications, most of the applications would be developed based upon the component library, whether you might have write a wrapper on the existing component library, or else you can write your component library from the scratch. Anything is okay. But while you're writing this component library, you need to have a best documentation such that all the teammates can use that up to its mark. Like just they can go to the component and they can copy the code. They can just see how it works. So this is what the documentation means. So here the documentation, you no need to prepare everything like this. So the storybook dependency will be taken care of all the things. So here the component name and how it looks when it is collapsed and expanded. So what is the source code here I need to use? So all this would be provided by the storybook itself. So this is about the documentation. The documentation should be absolutely fine. It should be the best documentation in terms of visualization, in terms of documentation. Like in terms of visualization, since you're playing around the components, in terms of copying and understanding the code. If you want to use any of the component, you can't go to the another components and you can't copy paste that component. You need to have some document, how to use the component, what all the properties, how it visualizes the component. So all things can be accumulated at one place. That is the docs. Here you can see the document. And in the canvas, you can play around the components, how it looks. So this is the second advantage you can have. So the best component library documentation you can prepare, but you no need to worry or you no need to keep long effort on this. So storybook dependency can be taken care. So we need to do some small changes to that. That's it. It will be taken care. So coming to the third point. Developers should be aware of what all the existing components. Let me explain you. Here, if you see, there are n number of components. If I'm a new developer in the team, there would be n number of developers developing all the different components. If I'm a new developer, I need to understand what all the components are already existing in the application. So that I should not develop the same component again. So here I will be coming here and I can type here some component like accordion. So here I can find. So as on when I searches here, the accordion component is filtered. It means accordion component is already exist. It is a developer friendly. So developer can know which component is exist, which component he needs to create. So in that way, it helps us a lot. If the components are more, if the team members are more, the communication, it will be a good communication of making what all the components exist and what all the components needed. So in terms of testing, and knowledge share. So in terms of testing, you can test the independent components individually. You can test a component, independent component as it is. So usually we test a unit test for the component code, whereas you will not test the component, isolated component in anywhere. So in that case, you can test this component here. in the storybook. Also, it shares the knowledge share a lot. So how to use a component, how to pass the properties to the component. In many ways, it can be helped for us. So also the fifth point is like style guide between the UX and UI. So there will be UX will be given in the Figma or Adobe, and the UI would be developed. So where to be compared? So exactly the both are matching or not. This would be the best place for the business people to be compared, or for the UX guys to compare whether the UX is designed properly or not. UI is designed as per the development or not. So whatever you see here, the storybook helps us a lot in terms of whatever you see here, it will be replicated same in the application as well. So that's the main point. So here till now we have seen what all the purposes and what all the importance, how the storybook helps us. So now we'll see what all the how to implement the storybook. So this is the official storybook website. So here I have selected the framework as React. So you can select Vue, Angular of your interest. So here I'm selecting React as a storybook. Let me show you how the storybook works, how to integrate the storybook with the React application. So I have taken an application. This is based upon a create React app. So just type this command, npx. This is an execution command. I'm trying to create a create React app. The application name is my storybook. Here I am just doing and creating a React application here. So once you have done this, so I'm done that. It takes more time, so I have done earlier. So now, after installing this or creating a React application, the second thing you need to do is you need to add the storybook dependency. So this is what the command to add all the storybook dependencies. Once you are done with this, you need to run this npm run storybook. So if once you run this storybook, what happens? It will open in a new tab, localhost 6006. The interesting thing is storybook runs in a different port. It will not disturb any of the main application. So here, if I want to run the application, I need to run the application with npm start. So npm start would be the normal application it would be running. So to run the storybook, I need to use this npm run storybook. So it runs in this port 6006. So once if you run this after installing all the storybook dependencies, it looks in this way. The default storybook UI UX, it would be looked in this way. So the default components here would be provided. For example, the button. So if you see the button is in this way. And also it will provide what all the properties the button accepts. So see, it has a background color. You can play around here itself. So if I select this, false, true, and also I can change the label, I can increase the size, everything. You can play around all its properties here itself. And also you can have the actions. If you go here, actions, if I click this, the action events also would be triggered. So in this way, you can play around the components with and its properties. So let me explain you a few more points. Like with this storybook, you have a number of options here. So for example, in the document, if you go here, whatever you see here, that would be get in the application. So if you develop a button like this, own the alignment, everything, it looks in this way when you integrate that in your real application as well. So that is what it helps. So if you want to use the code of this button, just click show code here. So you can just straight away, you can use this code to use this button component. So of course, this may be a small example to understand the storybook, but you can have a number of components in this way. You can take this as a reference and you can develop your storybook. So let me show you the code. So these are all the properties you can refer. So these are all the different kind of buttons, like secondary button, large button. So you can use different buttons like this. So let's see the code, how it is there. So we have not wrote anything. It was defaultly given by the storybook. Let's see this. So here, when we install all the storybook dependencies in the SRC, there would be another folder would be created called stories. In this stories, all the components would have button.stories.js. So later point of time, if you want to build any story to the component, you need to give the component name like this. So if the component name is like button.js, the story name should be button.stories.js. So here, if you observe, it was defaultly created by StoryBook dependency. This is a button component. It accepts some properties like this. So this, in this way, you can build your own components in your component folder as well. You can create component folder in the SRC and you can include that component here. Here, what he's doing is button.stories.js. In this file, he's referring to this button.js component. So how he is doing, he's imported that component, and every time the template, if he uses this template, it is a JavaScript way of creating duplicate functions. So a number of times he's doing template bind so that he's creating that many components, like primary component, secondary component, large and small, all these different components he has built. So only thing is we need to do like this. So this is the only part we need to do. So you need to take a template bind and you need to bind this template component. So this would be the component. So you have imported that button component here. And now you can pass the properties whichever you want. So whatever stories you declare here, that would be appeared here as a left navigation. So here you would have large number of options like finding, and here you have add-ons. There will be a number of add-ons for the StoryBook. You can refer. This is a official site. You can refer those examples. So here one of the example like GitLab UI. I have taken this GitLab UI. I'm showing. So there are a number of design systems and component libraries, and also there are some add-ons which will help us to directly config and modify the changes directly to the StoryBook. So this is all about StoryBook. Hope you understand. And the important point I want to cover here is, so let me show you once. So this is similar to like a Postman, like for the backend developers, there would be Postman, right? So which would be like a visualization, like he can add the header, body, and he can see the response what we are getting. Without UI only, the backend guys can play with the backend their APIs. So in the similar way, the StoryBook is for the UI developers. They can play around it as a playground. And coming to this StoryBook, it is highly recommended for the next generation, next level, to be built our components to the next level. If you want to take our UI development components to the next level, it's highly recommend to use the StoryBook. Hope you understand the video. Thanks for watching.